Hey, it's me, Alicia, with AP Lazer, and today I'm going to be showing you how to engrave multiple tumblers at once using our 4836LR machine and LightBurn. I'm going to set up a basic jig to have the tumblers set up in there. I'm using an acrylic sheet in our machine, so I'm going to get our material sized here. I'm just going to go over here and click on this rectangle guy, draw out my rectangle here, and we're going to change the dimensions to match the dimensions of the acrylic that we're using as our jig. And my acrylic is 40 by 35 inches. Go ahead and lock that in there so we have those dimensions set. And then I'm also going to go down here to the bottom of LightBurn. We have our T1 and our T2 layers here. And I'm just going to, it doesn't matter which one you select, I'm just going to go ahead and select T1. And all that's going to do is turn that into a template layer so that it doesn't cut, it doesn't engrave, it's just for your reference. Once we have that set, I can go ahead and start setting up the array for the jig. So I'm going to go back to my rectangle tool here. I'm going to drag that out. We can leave that as a tool layer for now, but I'm going to size this rectangle to the size of our cup here. Now, our cups are about 7 by 4. You can go ahead and measure it out if you're not sure. Just do the height and the length here. 7 by 4. So we're just going to go ahead and do that. So I'm going to go ahead, get this rectangle set here. Make sure it's unlocked so it can edit both dimensions here. We have a width of 4 and a height of 7. And we can just kind of keep this as a tool layer for now. And the next step that we're going to do, since we have that set, is we're going to go to our Create Array tool right here. Click on that. It opens up all these different kind of things here. And all we're going to need to do is edit how many columns we want in the X and the Y. Now, you can edit the spacing as well. So if I add 2 here, you can kind of change this. If I want it, you know, 1/2 inch apart, you can do that and change it. And you see how those get closer there. But I think about 1.5 inches apart works pretty well, just so there's some breathing room between the cups, so you can, you know, work well there. So I'm going to make sure that the X and the Y are spaced about the same, so everything is nice and good to go there. And we're just going to get this, and we're going to fit as many rectangles as we can on the material. Just keep going up, so I can fit 7 across there. Zoom out so I can see the top. And just keep adding till I hit the top. So 7 by 4. Great. Once everything looks good there, just go ahead and press OK. Make sure you press OK and not exit or escape. I do that a lot, and then it just resets you back to the 1 square. So just make sure you hit the OK button when you're ready to go. So now I have this nice array set out, and I can just, you can see where I fit all these different tumblers in here. And you can all of a sudden, you can do 28 tumblers at a time versus just the one. It's super helpful for doing that. So once we have all our rectangles in here, we're gonna need to cut them out on the material we have. So we're just gonna take these rectangles here, and you're just gonna go ahead and set that to a cut layer. So if we select all of these guys, just change the material over here. It can be any of these colors, just not T1 or T2. And then make sure this is set to line and mode. And just change the settings to whatever material you're using to cut the jig out of. I'm using acrylic, so I have a speed of 1, a max power of 97, and a min power of 95. Now, separating the max power and the min power just helps with the curve so that it's not so jagged when it's running. And that helps everything cut out smoothly. Once that's ready to go, just hit OK. And then we can go ahead, send it over to the machine, and let it cut out that before we set up our engraving in LightBurn. Once we have that set, we can start importing our logos in here. Now, I like to import PNG files just because they're easy to work with in LightBurn. This can be whatever design file you have. If you have JPEG, you know, whatever works for you, you can import those in. So just go ahead and hit import. Find your logo. I have my AP Lazer logo right here. And I could just run this as an image layer, but because it's so simple, I'd like to just vectorize it. I think it turns out a little bit cleaner because it's doing the lines back and forth versus the dots. So what I'm going to do is make sure I have my logo selected here. Right click. We're going to go down to trace image right here. Make this a little bigger so we can see what's happening. So we have our logo here and we have our threshold slider right here. We don't need to worry about cutoff. Take our threshold slider, slide that out until we have everything selected. You can see if I go back, it doesn't kind of quite get everything with that first bit there. So I'm just going to click a couple times until everything is wrapped in that pink and then hit the OK. And then we have our outline there. Now I'm going to want to make sure that I change this to a layer that is going to engrave. So we want to make sure it's not set to the tool layer, but it is set to engrave. Now, obviously, we're going to need to rotate this to fit on the cup. So I'm going to do up here, rotate negative 90, hit enter, and that's all set there. And then we can size it appropriately. I think a height of 5 will be plenty. And then if I go ahead and ungroup these guys here, so it's just this one here, select my logo, select my rectangle here. And if we hit the target button up here, it's gonna center it on there. So once the cup is in there, it's going to be centered on there and work perfectly. Now you could, if you wanna run, you know, 28 of these guys, all you need to do with both of these selected, the rectangle and that logo there, do the array again and just do the same thing we did before. 7 by 4. And you see everything is perfectly centered in there. It's gonna run everything, so all these cups are gonna end up the same and it's gonna look great. And you know, you could import another logo in there and do the same kind of thing. If you wanna do 28 different logos, that's fine. If you wanna do 2 different logos, just the one logo, whatever works for you. Do the same thing here. You're gonna do trace image. Hit it a couple times until that outline in pink. Great. Rotate it to negative 90. Do about 5 inches tall. And then we'll center it on this rectangle here. Perfect. And then if we wanna line these guys up, do the same thing with the array. Smooth that up. And then move this up to 4. And then we can get rid of the ones that aren't gonna fit on the material. But you know, that's how you go about doing that. And you can do that with as many logos as you'd like to get everything lined up the way you need to. Now, once we have those set, we wanna make sure that our fill settings are set to the correct settings here. So for our tumblers that we sell in our web store, and pretty much, you know, this will work with Yetis, this will work with Stanleys. They're all about the same. You need to play with them a little bit. But for the powder coated tumblers that we sell ourselves, we like to suggest a speed of 20 and a max power of 75. And this will work for our 90 watt systems, our 100 watt systems. You might need to up the power a little bit more for you know, our smaller systems like the 1812 or the 2616. But for the 2816, the 4024, and the 4836, those are all 100 watt, 90 watt, 100 watt systems. And the 2075 settings will work perfectly for that. So once we have those settings correct, we're just gonna go ahead, make sure we have this set to the origin we want, and send it over to the machine. So with the engraving, because we're just setting the cups down flat onto the bed of the machine, they're a little bit uneven. So we're going to go ahead and use a 4-inch lens to do this. Now the 4-inch lens has a different focal point that allows it to engrave evenly on slightly uneven surfaces. The 2-inch lens doesn't quite cut it on slanted surfaces. It's going to engrave some parts really well, and other parts is going to go out of focus and not really engrave it. So I just recommend using the 3 or the 4-inch lens. The 4-inch lens definitely is most recommended, as it can get through those curves no problem.